Hello everyone, and welcome back to Semi Control Chaos. Before we get into this video, I'm going to cover a couple that I missed from the last video from the PlayStation 2. We have Resident Evil Code Veronica X. I've never played this game. I think I put it in the system to see if it booted up. I heard this is the hardest one in the series. It's supposed to introduce a couple really interesting mechanics or something. I know this was the last big game before Resident Evil 4, where they completely changed the formula. And the last one is Evil Dead, A Fistful of Boomstick. I have played through this one enough to know that I like it, but it is kind of difficult. Like, I got to the part where all the tornadoes or whatever are in the town, and they hurt you, and I haven't figured out what to do with that quite yet, so I've put this on hold. But I was playing this not too long ago, and I'm thinking about going back to it. So, as always, if you want to see me play any of these games, just leave a comment down below. Now, today we're going to be going over my Game Boy SP game collection, or just Game Boy Advance collection. The thing that this is yes, I can record. Let me just go ahead and do this. I can record gameplay, like so. Just put the camera, like, right here. But this will be the view for most of it, like this. And I guess that'd be okay for a recording, but I really wouldn't want to do it in such a guerrilla filmmaking way. I really want to get the Retron 5 or a GameCube with the adapter so that you can play this on a TV. But I can play these and I can film it, but I'm really, really wanting to at least have the Retron or something where I can record this in a way that is not so guerrilla. So, we'll get into it with this game first, Frogger Adventures, Temple of the Frog. I remember playing this as a kid and it was really, really hard, and I went back to this, I don't know, 2-3 years ago, and I found it severely easier. I guess my skills have just gotten better, or I figured out patterns better, I don't know, but I think I got through like half the game before I just quit. Because I lost interest and just haven't picked it up since. It's not a bad game. I just haven't had time for it. Because I have so many other games that I play. Alright. Moving on. We have Namco Museum. It's just a collection of a bunch of basically Atari games. Space and Defenders, a Pac-Man, Miss Pac-Man, etc. I think Mario Brothers and Donkey Kong might be on this. I could be wrong. But I know there's like a bunch of those old, like, Atari, Coleco, whatever games on it. Alright. I picked this up just because I didn't know what it was. It's a Game Boy Advance video card. It was Yu-Gi-Oh! I kept this. I debated giving this away, selling it so many times, but I kept it just because I've never seen another video card. I'm sure there's plenty of them. But basically, they stick an episode or maybe two on this little cartridge, and it's in 144p, I believe. It's not very pretty, but you could technically watch TV on the road back then, I guess, with these. So, it's not really a game, but I figured I'd throw it in there just for, you know, whatever sakes. Ooh, yes. Got this in my special little case here. Pokemon Sapphire. Interestingly enough, this generation was the first Pokemon series I really got into. I was around when the first couple games came out, or relatively around that time. I think Gold and Silver were the really big games when I was just a little kid. But I started playing this series when I was in 5th grade. I think Diamond and Pearl had just come out at that point. But I think the actual first game I have was Emerald. I picked this up later because I found out you needed the other games to get the other Pokemon, and a lot of my friends had already moved up to a DS and sold their SPs or Advances or whatever the fuck they had, so I just kind of had to make do. Let's see. Moving on, we have Bomberman Tournament. Basically just a Bomberman game for the Game Boy Advance. I can't remember too much about it other than it's Bomberman. Alright, this is a little rough, but it's Rayman Advance. I can't remember much about this game besides I remember it being very hard. It's a Rayman game. They're usually pretty difficult. If you've watched my PlayStation 1 video, you'll know that I actually hate one of these games. Probably the most that I hate any game, which is the Rayman Brain Games video game. It's a pain in the ass. It takes advantage of your boredom. It has standard Rayman difficulty. It's just a complete formula for shit. And I hate it. Now, this game's not that bad. This game's actually pretty good. But the other game, it sucks ass. So before I ramble on about that too much, I have Super Mario Advance. I think this is the Super Mario 2, I think, is on this. I believe that's the game. It's either that or Super Mario 1. I can't remember exactly which game it is. But I remember it's a pretty good port of a Mario game for the Advance. So, oh, here we go. Yu-Gi-Oh! The Sacred Cards. I played the shit out of this game, and honestly, I still go back to it every now and again. Because it's an interesting game because it offers a fair challenge up until the last boss fight, to where you just have to win by absolute luck or do nothing but grind up until you're like super level. But typically you just have to get lucky in the last boss fight, because he has severely overpowered cards. And another cool little feature, if you actually own any of the cards, you can put in the code and it'll give you that card in the game. Provided it's not past this series or timeline, like the new stuff won't work. But I'm trying to remember what generation it was. I can't remember. Just whatever generation it was when they first introduced the dual discs. That one, yeah. Where America was the main villain. All right, now we have Pokemon Leaf Green. I'm kind of pissed off about this, honestly. Well, it's way lighter than it is in actuality. I wonder what the other game's gonna look like. I had Fire Red, and I lost it, and I was so pissed off that I lost it, and then I found it again, and now I've lost it again, and I have no idea where the fuck it is, and I'm guessing I'm just gonna have to buy another version, because this is a good version to have, whatever, but I want my Fire Red game back. Mainly just because you need both of them to collect all the Pokemon, blah, blah, blah. But there's a couple of these older games that I really have to pick up. Just because, you know, I want to be able to have the complete set. And I have to go around begging people for, oh, can I have this Pokemon for whatever? And most people probably don't even have this shit by now. They've sold all their stuff to go on and get the next big stuff. As is, you know, the way most people do stuff these days. They don't keep a hold of their stuff they don't keep their stuff for very long these days. Alright, so now we have Donkey Kong Country. Basically, from what I understand, this is a port of the Super Nintendo game Donkey Kong Country. I played it, it's very addicting, it's very good. I have never beat this game. It's hard as balls. Like steel balls here. We're not talking about just dirt balls, man. This is like balls of steel levels of hard. At least to me. I imagine people who have played this all their life are like really good at it, but I kind of suck at the game. It's a good game, but I'm not good at it. Alright. This is a game I really like. Cartoon Network Speedway. You can play as Johnny Bravo, Courage the Cowardly Dog. Sadly, I don't think you can play as Ed, Edd n Eddy. Sadly, my favorite character to play is Courage, because he gets the flying saucer, and I think he's actually the fastest character. I try to remember who else you play as. I think you might be able to play as Cow and Chicken and Dexter from Dexter's Laboratory. Basically Mario Kart, just Cartoon Network, from what I understand. It's a really good game if not many people actually know about it. Everyone I've talked to has never played it. But it's a really good game. If you see it, it's worth it. Alright, now for the last game from my collection. My first Pokemon game of all time, and boy is that label fucked. Pokemon Emerald. This is by far my favorite Pokemon game ever, probably just because it's my first, yada yada. I think this is the only game where I have a level 100 Pokemon of any kind. This is the one I religiously play if I'm ever playing any. Now I have to see something real quick, just do like a color test. Ooh boy. These look like reproduction cards through the camera. But I swear they're legitimate. What the hell? It's like the light's like not liking it or something. Oh well. Just gonna put this in the case. It's really hard to do one-handed. Give me just a second. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. It's boring. Oh, there's nothing on screen. Oh, what am I gonna do? What am I gonna do? Hurry, hurry, hurry before they click off. Okay, so these other games are gonna be from my little sister's collection. Now, the only reason I brought these out was on the off chance that any of these games are either really, really good and I think they're really, really bad, or what I really hope to happen is they're so bad they're hilariously good. So I'm just gonna bring them out, put them out there, and if a game is just so horrendously bad that it's funny, I will play it. So I'll start off this strong with That's So Raven. I don't remember anything about this show. I don't remember ever watching this show. I know nothing about it. But if this happens to be one of those so bad it's good games, I'll give it a shot. Hamtaro. I remember this cartoon anime when I was a kid. But I don't see it too much today. I don't see it referenced. I don't think I've even heard that name anywhere except for this game in the last probably 10 years. Well, 5 years actually. I remember hearing it once with a group of friends who we were talking about old cartoons. The Ham Ham Heartbreak. I remember watching my sister play this. It's apparently not very bad. It's just really boring, so I don't imagine too many of you would want to see me play this game. How about a good game? Yeah. Super Mario World, Super Mario Advance 2. I can't remember too much about this game. Like, I can't remember if it's a port of something else or if it's a completely new game. But if you guys want to see me play this, I will definitely do that. Okay. Penguins of Madagascar, Operation Penguin. Again, a game I know nothing about. But if you guys want to see me play it, just leave a comment down below and I will get right on it. The Cat in the Hat. With Mike Myers in it. I believe this is his game anyway. If I remember right, this game is one of those so bad it's just bad games. I don't remember there being anything good about this when I watched my little sister play. It's like they just pushed this out as fast as they could for the movie, which often happens with these movie games. Speaking of movie games, Finding Nemo. I can't remember anything about this game either. I think it was just really hard for whatever reason, if I remember it right. So, moving on, we have Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban. Now, if you watched the PlayStation 2 video, you know I actually had two copies of the PlayStation 2 version of that. I never played this version. I, again, know nothing about it. So, if you want to see it played, just leave a comment down below, or actually, if any of these games are bad or good, just leave a comment down below so as I can know without actually having to just go in there and play through all of them to know. Because I kind of want to go into it blind so as I get the most surprise out of it. If that makes any sense. Alright, last game from her stash. Nicktoons Unite. I played this game on the PlayStation 2. I'm fairly sure it was in there somewhere. In the PlayStation 2 video. So that'll do it for that game collection. Trying to make sure I get all these piles in here and still manage to have a decent shot. Just trying to surround my SP in games. Yeah, there we go. That's a decent shot. Alright, so thank you all for stopping by for this quick little video. Another reason why I included her games in this was just because, well, just these games of mine, the stash is cut down like in half, so with this way there's a lot more opportunity to play games. A lot more variety, I guess. And again, if any of these are just so bad they're actually funny or good, that would be a plus. Because out of her stash, I can only think of maybe Super Mario and maybe Nicktoons Unite being good. Maybe the Hamtaro game is good. I don't know. I really don't know anything about most of these games over here. So, anyway, if you guys like this video, please like, share, and subscribe. It really helps me out, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.